Welcome everyone, it's Vapors Drakemar. It is time for some more Raid Shadow Legends. I decided for a different build. So crit damage. Crit rate. So we're definitely going to want crit rate percent. Alright, so we're gonna go for this kind of build and see how this goes. I don't think the other build is that good. Perception. Because I'm like trying to figure out what kind of build is going to give him some damage, but isn't going to be excessively squishy. Because I don't think Immortal is the build you want. Trying to fix my bloody armor. That's more like it. take a good look at perception here. That might be my best option. Roll it to a minimum of 8. Stop it! Oh my god, Linnaeus, you're such a vermin! Garbaggio. Alright, so we got some accuracy in our build. Critical rate's been boosted way the hell up. This seems to be a more reasonable build. Yeah, why not? At least we kept our bone knight. Right. I do have to check their gear later. But yeah, that does seem to be a much better build. So yeah, I am kind of glad that I kept the bone knight. We will be upgrading him soon. I don't know, and I don't think that we can beat the boss. You have to develop food eventually for that faction. Wow, that just exploded that. Putting better gear on her. Bogoth was a amazing find for this faction. Like, an amazing find. I will be doing a little bit more later. I need more silver. I need to upgrade my Death Knight. Get him to 42. I have serious indigestion from this whole event, so I'm not in the greatest mood. See, now he does his job. Hope he's not too squishy. Cause now he starts to slam. This is the kind of damage I was hoping for before. He can do his job. Hey! Yeah, that's what we want. That's what we want. That's what I remember Armiger for. There we go. There we go. That's what I remember Armiger for. We finally got the build okay, guys. The build isn't garbage. Well, is relatively not as garbage as it was. See? He does the turn meter thing. Yeah, he does the turn meter thing. It's not perfect, but it'll do. Just had to get some crit rate on him. That's not too bad. It's perception gear, defense gear. Now let's see if we can wait. Hey! That's what I want to see. He's not quite the level, but that's what I want to see out of him. Hey! Not all the time, but still. It's still decent. I'm cutting it kind of close, but that's what I want to see. I'm finally getting Armiger to do Armiger things. If it's not perfect, but this is better. Ah, yes! Yes, now this is the kind of thing I want. That other gear, that didn't feel right. That didn't feel right. That felt bad. Shouldn't feel bad to play Armiger. It should be okay, you know? That's why I was concerned. I'm like, something fishy going on with the Armiger. That's what it is. Because I was like, yeah, this guy, yeah, see? He now does his job. Granted, I have thrown him a bunch of silver to fix it entirely. But what's new? What's new? Like, I'm sorry, but that's what I got to try to do for this event. I've got to try to get my Armiger to do something. Can we lay him to rest? Hey! There we go! There we go. That's the Armiger I know. That's the Armiger I know. There we go. There we go. Hey. Hey, that's it. This is it. This is the build. This is what we want him at. This is what we want him at. This is what we want him at. Granted, we want him with a little more oomph in terms of levels, but that's not half bad. Because the problem is, Doom Tower is like a very rough test of your block revive skill. Like, if you don't have like your stuff in a row, you're not gonna make it. You're not gonna make it. That's the problem with Doom Tower. That's the thing about it. You're not gonna make it if you don't put in your resources. That's the thing. Doom Tower is a very severe test of skill and knowledge of the game. Well, that's part of the problem. Still working on some of this food. But as you can clearly see, Hunger is in a lot better spot than he was. He's in a lot better place, and it's only going to improve from here. Because, yeah, I found some gear that works on him. And he's kind of tanky, so. Hopefully, it'll be enough, but you kind of have to have one max level if you can. If you can. Because, yeah, he needs a lot of resources. This thing and decreases the turn meter and everything. Can block revive? Yeah! Yeah, this. Now, this is where we want him at. This kind of deal. This is the kind of deal you want him at. This. This is the kind of deal you want him at. I'm gonna save it for the daily, which, come to think of it, should not be far off. Let's explore for Valerie's, maybe. Nah. We've got a very specific mission to do. Involving Minotaur. And we all know how fun that is. But yeah, I found a way to make Armiger work, guys. Now it's back to the But yeah, because generally you want your Armiger to do some damage. Generally speaking. Because if your Armiger doesn't do any damage, you're in hot water. I mean, Kale could work for Doom Tower if I had him in the right gear and mastery. As you can clearly see, he is not doing what he needs. You can clearly see that. Probably needs Savage Gear instead of that or lifesteal. So I don't rate what he's currently in. What he's currently in is a problem. Problem is, I don't have enough silver now. I'm trying to gear an Armiger this whole time. I'm trying to find a gear set that like works even half decent. Because the one thing this game really messes you over on is armor. The one thing this game really loves to mess you over on. I'm trying to figure out what gear set combination works is expensive and difficult. Really expensive and difficult. because my main objective here was to figure out what was I going to use for armor. My main objective here is to try to get some gears and masteries. That's my general theme with that. I go to this one because I know for a fact that they won't just give me the plane scroll. There's like a 0% chance. So I gotta check under masteries. Because him having masteries would be big. I'm just glad he like finally does something. Other than trying to Elhain that out. Decreases the max HP. Yeah, he's gonna throw that doom. So yeah. Don't want Death Knights, man. I already have one of those. A bunch of them. I'll even check to see if his skills are upgraded. Just have to get him to 40. There. Well, you see, I could have upgraded the Saurus to full. I just don't feel in the mood. Because... I don't feel in the mood because I'm trying to upgrade an Armiger. And Armiger is like MVP in a lot of content. So that's the reality of it. Armiger is MVP in a lot of content. And that's why I'm trying to develop one. That's why I'm working my butt off trying to do it. Because I know that if I get him up to par... If I get him up to par, he's gonna kick some butt. Some serious butt. So where is my admonitor? He will eventually be used. I feel he is underused, Ed Monitor. All right, so we're gonna shove all of them up on this one. And then go start hunting for twos. Because twos is where it's at. Yeah, no. I don't like upgrading ones. Upgrading ones is such a waste of time. Since it's a dupe, I'll use it later for food, maybe. Or like maybe to upgrade the skills of somebody, like another Hyria. Now, I know this is going to be controversial, but instead of upgrading another food champ, there's a very specific champion I'm aiming to upgrade. Now, you guys may not like me to do this, but this very specific champion needs a buff. You may ask why. Well, I'll tell you. The reason why I'm doing this for him is because he is eventually going to be a major component of some stuff. There's no point of pulling the better shards unless the event is truly good. Yeah, there's no point. Yeah, Chevalier. You may ask, why on earth would you try to upgrade a Chevalier? Well, I'll explain. He has a skill known as Ally Protect. This skill is incredibly valuable. Incredibly valuable for a lot of content. Specifically, Clan Boss. I have been neglecting him for some time, and it is time that I give him some recognition. He is not food. He is actually a very powerful. He's one of the only champions in the game with Ally Protect. I want to emphasize this point. I want to emphasize why Chevalier is so special. I want to emphasize that massively. Because Chevalier is going to be able to protect my team in Clan Boss. I can run a double Ally Protect team comp with him on it. You don't really understand how special he is. Watch. He gets the shield. He has a shield. I think he even has that move. His Ally Protect. I have to look at what his move with Ally Protect is. almost. But yeah, Chevalier, ladies and gentlemen. I wanna investigate this champ more. I really think he's valuable and underrated. He crits a lot more now. A lot more. That's what I wanted out of this game. That move, later rest, that's big. That's really big. I want everyone to understand how big that move is. Because once he gets to the point where he can properly use it, like now, once he gets that, it's really powerful. I thought he had the ally defense. He still has, like, defense. And he's still a banner lord, so that. He's still void affinity. I still think he's gonna do a lot more when he grows up. We'll leave him there for now, but when he grows up, he's gonna turn into a monster. I'm still trying to raise an Armiger, although my Armiger is nearly completed his training and is ready to cover the front lines of Doomkill. You see how strong he's getting? Yeah, he's nearly there. If I get him to 50, he should have what he needs. Because his walk revive is getting stronger, his gear is getting stronger, he is getting whipped into shape. Sure, it's not critting every time, but it's critting a lot of the time. And that's all we really need him to do. I'm still going to be upgrading Chevalier, don't get me wrong, but Armiger is still MVP. That's what I want to see. That skill. That's what we've raised him this whole time to do, is that skill. That's the skill. That right there. The first one was a failure. So that's what Perfect. And that, I think, will do it for now. We want the next episode. We're gonna do a Minotaur, and then in the next episode, we're gonna go back to my other account. But yeah, that's what we wanted to. That's how we wanted it to go. Right? That's how we wanted it to go. I was really hoping to fix this. The reason I'm trying to fight all this stuff out is because I'm desperately trying to make sure that I've got my ducks in a row. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get my champions with their scrolls. It's not like I can't do the Minotaur. Not but I don't want the scroll. Because I do. I want the scrolls in these suckers. That's what I'm trying to give them. I've got an idea. Does it give you more scrolls if you go it solo? Or with like one person with completed scrolls and one isn't? Does it give me more scrolls to the character that does that? Cause if so, we could complete Virgus's scrolls, at least for his tier 3 masters. I've just thought of that. Yeah. Maybe that's how I can get his scroll faster. Because here's the thing. The most important one with the one that I want the scrolls on the most is Virgus. You may ask why. Good question. Well, you see, Virgus is usually, in a lot of situations, my MVP. In the whole thing. He is the MVP. That's why I want him to have the scrolls. I think maybe it distributes the scrolls a bit too much. If you do that. He really does slam at this difficulty, doesn't he? But you would expect. That's right, we're gonna duo the Minotaur. kind of hard to do this duo with the Virgus, but Virgus is a great protector, so he should be fine. He can solo it if all else fails, which is what it looks like gonna happen once again. Because yes, Virgus can solo Minotaur. Before you ask. I'm doing this as an experiment. They're like, oh, Count Virgus can solo Brutal, that's so amazing. It's like, oh, you've seen nothing yet. You have seen nothing yet, because your Virgus is not developed. Because this is the kind of thing the Virgus can do when developed. You develop him, ooh, he turns evil. Get put destroy gear on him, ooh, he could solo Nightmare Campaign. Literally solo Nightmare Campaign. That is what Virgus is capable of. And he could solo a lot of arena teams too. Yeah, low level arena teams, no. Yes sir, Bob, you can. Look at that damage. See how long he can take this for. Although destroy gear is gonna help in this process, man. So. Look how much health this sucker has. It's almost like once you get to this point. It's very hard to actually solo him, but solo him you can. It just takes a while. A very long while to actually solo him. But as you can see, it's clearly doable. Have too much in the way of burst at this point, so you can probably just kill him. Kinda like Scarab Boss. It will take a while, obviously, because these enemies are phenomenally tanky. As you can clearly see by how hard I have to work. And with this droid gear on, he has more health than freaking Scarab Boss. These guys have so much HP. Look at their HP bar. It's bare minimum. Even though they don't regen. Look at how little that health bar meant. That was a 12k hit. How much health did this nut bar have? Like, it's not as much as clan bars. Jeez, man. And where does he come from anyway? Like, is he the original Minotaur? Or is he a new Minotaur? Nobody explains anything about this boss other than he has his roles. I'm trying to get rid of these smaller ones, but it's gonna be an age. Alright, finally, one died. That decreased max HP adds up, as you can clearly see. He can't regen any of that. He can't regen any of his max HP, so all that red and black bars and diagonal, he can't regen that. Still don't know. So does his fire cloak goes into his eyes, right? Like, where is he storing the scrolls? Does he have them in his backpack? Or does he just like give it to one of his satyrs? Or where does he store his scrolls? These questions aren't answered. Like, I want some answers. Well, I'm gonna look up the lore right now. What the heck is the lore? Because I love to know. What is the lore behind the Minotaur's Labyrinth? Funny thing is, he can literally just pierce you to death if he can't ally protect someone. Because he is literally a human shield. Assume he takes increased damage after a bit. Oh no, he's smart. So he goes from raging to Blaze Bull. So we go from an powerful, okay, a Raging Bull and Daisy. I guess it just makes sure the scroll always goes to him. Is that what it does?